Hello friends, today we will derive the formulae or matrices for scaling about arbitrary point. So we have to derive the scaling matrix about arbitrary point xf and yf. Means earlier we were doing scaling with respect to origin, means for our case the scaling was done with reference to origin, means the reference point was origin. If the reference point, that is arbitrary point, is given, so we can use direct matrix for solving that matrix or solving that scaling matrix. So from in the figure ABCD, this is the figure ABCD which has some arbitrary point which is away from the origin, has arbitrary point xf and yf. So it is to be scaled such that it will become means final figure I will represent in dash form. So it will be A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. Means we have to scale this inner figure just like outer figure. So we have to obtain this outer figure. For that we all know will require scaling. So first of all we will bring the point A to origin. So for that we will require translation. So first transformation I will do, that is translation, because unless and until I will not bring the point A to origin, I can't perform scaling. So first translation, so we have to translate point A to origin. I am translating point A to origin, so I will require tx and ty value. Since I am moving from right to left, means in this direction in both x and y, and I am moving from upward to downward direction, means in this direction, so I have to travel xf unit in negative direction, that is minus xf unit, to reach to origin, and minus yf unit in upward to downward direction, that is minus yf, to reach this origin. So the tx will be minus xf and ty will be minus yf. So it will be minus xf and this will be minus yf. So standard translation matrix we all know, that is 1 0 0 0 1 0 tx ty. This is standard translation matrix. Now we will replace the value of tx and ty, then I will get the corresponding matrices as 1 0 0 0 1 0. Tx is minus xf, ty is minus yf, and last is 1. So this is the translation matrix. Now the figure is appeared somewhere. It will be like this way. Means this is A, B, C, and D. Means the figure has been brought to origin, and now we can perform scaling operation because scaling is done with reference to origin. So now we will do scaling. So because we have to enlarge the figure into A dash, B dash, C dash, and D dash. So now I will do scaling. Second transformation is scaling. So second scaling. So for scaling we require sx and sy, that is scaling along x direction and scaling along y direction. So sx and sy, and we know the standard scaling matrix as s equal to sx 0 0 0 sy 0 0 0 1. This is the standard scaling matrix. Now figure will be seen as, this is a figure to just understand how the figure will look after transformation. So the figure will be somewhat this way. Since we have enlarged the size, the So this is the enlarged size. So I am representing the enlarged size, that is scaled size or final size, as A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. So now scaling has been done. Since this point was away from origin, means it was having some reference point. So we have to place that A to the original position. So for that we will do back translation, means we are doing translation second time in this problem. So we will do back translation. So third is translation. We'll write as back translating point A. So it was having point that is xf and yf. It was having xf in x coordinates and yf in y coordinates. So we will require tx and ty value. In that case, we wrote minus xf and minus yf. So since we are doing back translation, just write opposite to that of first one. So it was minus xf, we'll refer. It was minus xf, and in ty, that is along y direction, it was minus yf. We will write just opposite to that of t1, since two translations are there. So I will represent this one as t1 and the second one as t2. So this will become xf, yf. So translation matrix is given as 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Tx is xf, ty is yf, and 1. So this is the standard translation matrix after replacing the value of xf and yf. So the figure now will be, this is just for understanding purpose, so it will be like this way. So I will represent as A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, since this is the final figure, and since it is away from origin, so it will have some arbitrary point, that is xf and yf. So the thing which we required, we have done. Now we have to find the resultant transformation, since we have to derive the scaling matrix about arbitrary point xf and yf. For that I will have to multiply all the matrices in the order which I have done. So resultant transformation TR, first I have done translation, that is T1, afterward I have done scaling, and afterward I have done second translation. So I will note down the matrices. T1 was 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. It was minus xf, minus yf, and 1. And scaling was sx, 0, 0, 0, sy, 0, 0, 0, 1. This was the scaling matrix. And last was translation T2, just opposite to that of T1. So 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. It was, here it was minus xf, I will write here as positive xf. Here it was minus yf, I will write there positive yf. So I will multiply all these matrices so that I will get total transformation, that is resultant transformation. So after multiplying all these matrices, the resultant transformation I get as sx 0 0 0 sy 0 xf 1 minus sx, yf 1 minus sy 1. This is the total transformation matrix. So tr, we have found the resultant transformation, means we have to use this matrices for find when arbitrary point has been given, that is scaling about arbitrary point xf and yf. It can also be called as SF. Okay. Thank you.